In this video, we get to take a look at what volume is. And a definition would be the measure of the amount of space occupied by any three-dimensional object. So let's take a closer look at that definition and how we can measure such things as volume. And you may notice, if you look around wherever you happen to be, that just about everything you're looking at has three dimensions. It has height, it has width, and it has depth. It doesn't have to be a regular shape like a box. It can be anything that has space within it. And the space doesn't have to be empty. It can be occupied by anything. So if it's a regular shape, we can simply calculate the space occupied by a box by simply measuring each side. So here we have three examples. So for example, here we have 4 centimeters on one side, 2 on another, and 5 centimeters on the third. So height, depth, and width. And if we look over to the right here, we can see this is a cube that has a measurement of 1 centimeter on each side. So measuring the amount of space occupied by this cube, we would have 1 centimeter as the height, 1 centimeter as depth, 1 centimeter as the width. And so that gives us 1 cubic centimeter of space. We've multiplied 1 centimeter by itself 3 times, 1 centimeter times 1 centimeter times 1 centimeter. So if we look at the box, the same idea applies, where we simply multiply the height times the width times the depth. So the question is, how many of these single cubic centimeters would fill a box with a height of 4 centimeters, a length of 5 centimeters, and a width of 2 centimeters? Well, let's take a look. So we'll bring the cube over and see how many fit the length of it. Well, we've measured 5 centimeters, and so we would expect 5 1-cubic-centimeter boxes to fit across the length. Let's look at the width. How many 1-cubic-centimeter boxes would fit across that width? Well, you guessed it, 2, but we still have that 5-centimeter length, and so we would fill that up with a total of 5 boxes. And now what's left is the height, 4 centimeters. So the question is, how many 1-cubic-centimeter boxes would fit a height of 4 centimeters? And we already have 1, so a second, a third, and a fourth. And we've already filled in the length with 5 boxes. And now we have the width of 2 centimeters left to fill in. So we have the first 5, the second 5, the third 5, and the fourth 5. And so what we've done is fill up the box with as many 1-cubic-centimeter cubes as we can. And what that turns out to be is simply the measurements of each side multiplied 4 centimeters times 2 centimeters times 5 centimeters gives us 40 cubic centimeters of space. So therefore, we would say the volume is 40 cubic centimeters, 40 of these 1-cubic-centimeter boxes. And to bring that point home, let's actually count all the boxes. Yep, there are 40 cubic centimeters in that 4 by 2 by 5 centimeter box. So any regular space where you can take the measurement of each dimension, you can use those measurements to figure out the volume. So let's say you have a cylinder. We measure the cylinder to be 20 centimeters in height and 2.5 to 4 centimeters in diameter. If you know how to get the area, the radius, which is half the diameter squared times pi, in other words, pi r squared, that gives you the area of the cylinder, and it's 20 centimeters in height. And so when you multiply pi times the radius squared, giving you the area, times 20 centimeters the height, that's going to give you 100 cubic centimeters. So if we had the cylinder and it's hollow, when we filled it up with water, the amount of water we could put in it is 100 cubic centimeters. What if we only filled the water up to 10 centimeters? Well, then we'd have pi r squared, the area, times 10 centimeters, and that would give us a total of 50 cubic centimeters. And we can do the same with 6 centimeters. That would give us 30 cubic centimeters. And what if we filled it up to 14 centimeters? Well, that would give us 70 cubic centimeters. And so by doing this, what we can do is create markings simply by how high the water is to mark the volume of that height of water or whatever you happen to be filling it with. And so these markings are called graduations on the side of a cylinder, and they tell you the volume of a liquid filled to that mark. So what we can do here is see how what is called a graduating cylinder is made. It's simply markings on the side of a cylinder that goes according to the diameter and the height of the cylinder, however it happens to be made. The one that I'm showing you here, we've shown that at a height of 20 centimeters, it has a volume of 100 cubic centimeters. And a graduated cylinder would go a little bit above that with a pouring spout. And so that's a common piece of equipment used in laboratories all around the world. That's it for volume.